sisters, such confidence we have in Christ toward God. Not that of ourselves we are qualified to take credit for anything that's coming from us. Rather, our qualification comes from God, who has indeed qualified us as ministers of a new covenant, not of letter, but of spirit. For the letter brings death, but the spirit gives life. Now, if the ministry of death, carved in letters on stone, was so glorious that the children of Israel could not look intently at the face of Moses because of its glory that was going to fade, how much more will the ministry of the Spirit be glorious? For if the ministry of condemnation was glorious, the ministry of righteousness will abound much more in glory. Indeed, what was endowed with glory has come to have no glory in this respect, because of the glory that surpasses it. For if what was going to fade was glorious, how much more will what endures be glorious? The word of the Lord.
And thanks be to God.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Extol the Lord our God and worship at his footstool. Holy is he.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Moses and Aaron were among his priests, and Samuel among those who called upon his name. They called upon the Lord, and he answered them.
Holy is the Lord our God.
From the pillar of cloud he spoke to them. They heard his decrees and the law he gave them.
Holy is the Lord our God.
O Lord our God, you answered them. A forgiving God you were to them, though requiting their misdeeds.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Extol the Lord our God, and worship at his holy mountain, for holy is the Lord our God.
Holy is the Lord our God.
He allowed them to see it from a different angle. You know, when we look at something in the same position, we don't understand its totality. Comes with art, doesn't it? Sometimes our eyes maybe not be trained like an artist is. Susan, your eye is trained. You're a graphic designer, but there's some of us that look at it and enjoy beauty, but they don't see it in its totality, where an artist does. And part of the beauty of an artist is to draw you into the painting. They want you to enter into the painting. How often do we say that that's what Jesus wants us to do? You know, the miracles, the various teachings and sermons of Jesus, they're not just for that person that the miracle is being attributed to. Jesus is drawing us into the moment, because the miracle is for us. It's not just for that guy, that lady. He's drawing us into the moment, because the miracle is transformative for the believer. Not just the person that's getting the miracle. When I hear the Gospels, when you hear the Gospel, you all stand, don't you? Of course, because Jesus is calling us. We get up. Yes, Master. Yes, Lord. And Jesus, through the Gospel, says, I need to talk to you about this, because this Gospel is for you, for all of you. Like an artist, Jesus draws us in. And like those first followers, Jesus was explaining to them the beauty of God's presence in their life. He's not come to do away with what was. Let's face it, the Bible has two testaments, right? We call them the Old Testament. What is a testament? It's a covenant. It's a relationship. An Old Testament and a New Testament. Two lungs. God's breathing life into us. Jesus does not tell them to throw away the 46 books of the Old Testament. He doesn't tell them to throw away the laws. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. He doesn't tell them to do that. He doesn't tell them to throw away the prophet books, Isaiah, Jeremiah. I've come to fulfill them. I've come to fulfill them. Remember what we talked about, the Ten Commandments, the Decalogue? You know, and I told you that there's about 613 commandments in the law. In those first five books of the Bible, about 613. But the Decalogue, the Ten Commandments found in Exodus and Deuteronomy, sometimes they were very fixated on just the letter of the law. And then Jesus goes up to the other mountain where he gives the sermon. So there's Moses going up Sinai to get the law from God the Father. And here's Jesus going up this mountain to give the Beatitudes, the spirit of that. So both end, not either or. For them, Jesus becomes the new Moses, right? And so to understand the law of the prophets, not to throw them away, but let me understand it. Poor in spirit, the meek, those who are persecuted, those beautiful sermons that Jesus gave on the mount, fulfill this law, thou shalt not kill. If you just take it, you know, thou shalt not kill, take a gun and shoot somebody, take a knife and kill somebody, it's horrible, it's horrific, right? We should never take life. Because God's the author of life. Never take innocent life. Yet at the same time, Jesus helps us to understand the fulfillment of that. be a knife. Our tongue can slice and dice someone to shreds and hurt people. We have to make sure that weapon is not used to hurt, but to heal. I think if we just look at the law and the prophets for just face value and don't understand its spirit, but we're not really good followers of Jesus of Nazareth. It's always both and, never either or. It's understanding the totality of everything. Now, that wasn't so easy for the people of Christ's day, because they were very much fixated on not only the Decalogue, the Ten Commandments, but the 613 that were found in the Torah. So Jesus had to move them out of their comfortability box without throwing all of that away. He does that for us too. It's always both then. I'm a good person. I don't need to give an ass. I don't need to give a frisk. I'm a good person. I don't kill anybody. Our friends tell us that, right? You do need the Eucharist. You do need the sacraments. If not, why did Jesus even come? Why did his Father put him through all this? If it's not necessary, close the doors, shut the lights, let's go home. But it is necessary. We have to understand the totality of all of it, which means that you and I, who do believe, who do practice our faith, who do receive the sacraments, have to be also people of integrity, people of charity, people of love, people of kindness, both and. Never to see ourselves as righteous, or never to see ourselves as we've got all this. We're the good ones, they're the bad ones. No. But both and. Needing God. This is what Paul said to the church in Corinth. You heard this in the first reading. Brothers and sisters, such confidence we have through Christ toward God, not that of ourselves we are qualified to take credit, for anything is coming from us. Rather, our qualification comes from God. That's right. God does not call the qualified. He qualifies the called. And that's what Paul is saying to the church in Corinth. That's what he says to us. May God continue to allow his law and its spirit to penetrate our whole being so that we may be an efficacious sign of his presence. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For the church, may the power and grace of the Holy Spirit continue to help our persevere in bringing Christ's truth to all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected and appointed officials, may the Lord's wisdom inform their actions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who feel lonely or abandoned, may God's presence console them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may God send his Holy Spirit upon us to bless. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations in priesthood and consecrated life, especially from members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pretty gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they're in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, and through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and the work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, and through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the mind and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Take this, all of you, and drink from, for this is the chalice of together with Francis, our Pope, Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and before our divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Behold, a faithful and prudent steward, to give them their allowance of food at the proper time.
Thank you.
reminder of peace offering the Father's Day remembrance cards for both the living and deceased fathers of your family and our parish family. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice day, everybody.
Thank you, too, Father.
Saint Michael,
be our angel. Defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God.